desire, I think, especially with this kind of art where you're not trying to make a painting. It can be very intimidating to young artists when they take an art class and they are staring at this big blank sheet of paper. And whereas in journals, it's a quick sketch. You know, you don't think of it as having to be perfect. You know, it doesn't have to be perfect. And so to take that out of the equation, it's just about, so, you know, just to jar your brain a little bit and try to get you to do some things and maybe in different ways that you hadn't even thought about. That has work in a gallery and to be a professional and sell your work, that sort of thing. That's perfectly legitimate and fine. It's a different avenue than doing this kind of art, this sketchbook art, where this is really more a personal expression of you capturing the world around you for your own enjoyment. And so it takes a lot of that pressure off of having to make this painting that you might want to have to be framed and put on a wall. And you know, it's just a book. If one sketch doesn't turn out well, you turn the book and you go on. You know, you keep doing it, and the more you do it, the better you get at it. So I equate it to studying music, for instance. If someone handed you a violin and said play, you would, if you weren't already a musician, you would say, I don't know how to do that. I have to study. I have to learn. I have to take lessons. And so it's the same thing with art. You know, some people, yes, are more inclined towards it and have natural abilities and that sort of thing. That's undeniable. But anybody can draw. You can learn to draw. There are steps that you take and skills that you build on. And the important thing is just that you really have the desire to do it. And if you have that, then you will keep at it. And so after, if they've taken my class, I give them instructions in basic drawing skills and basically how to, you know, hold a brush and fill it with paint and just those basic things that people don't know how to do. You know, it's like, how do I do that? You know, so it's a matter of learning. And then after they've taken this, you know, after they've taken that first step, then, you know, then go on, take a drawing class. Now take a painting class. Now you've got this under your belt. You've got a little bit of experience. You're not coming upon it cold. So, and then just to keep at it, I encourage them to not tear pages out of their journals if they don't like it, because then later you go and look back and you think, wow, look, I really have learned. You know, I've grown and I'm getting better at this. So,